For more than 30 years, I've been a passionate competitive sailor. But I'm also a marine engineer and an ocean tech entrepreneur. Everything I do in life is related to the ocean. And my fascination for the ocean started right here in Arendal. From an early age, I spent days, months, and years pondering about the physics of sailing. And while my friends were reading Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings, my favorite book, this beauty, Sail Power. I wanted to understand the wind, the waves, and the current. And how is it possible to sail against the wind? And how is it possible to sail faster than the wind? These questions motivated me to pursue competitive sailing. And it has taken me all around the world, participating in countless competitions, among them the Olympics. And you may wonder, did I get the medal? I get that annoying question quite a lot and quite often. Well, let me put it this way. Fourth is better than fifth. Sailing is a highly complex sport. There's the unpredictable nature, fluid dynamics, teamwork, and not at least other competitors you cannot control. But there's one thing that's more important than anything else, boat speed. Reduce the drag and increase the propelling force of the sails. Don't waste any energy, be efficient. And efficiency equals speed. And being a lot faster than the competitors is highly satisfying and makes a sailor's life easy. But what do I mean by a lot faster? Is it 100% faster? 50% faster? No. By a lot faster in competitive sailing, I mean 1% faster. That is the mentality we're talking about. And being 1% faster than the competitors can easily be the difference between Olympic gold medal and a fourth place. And believe me, I know that. My goal is to bring this mentality into the industry of high-speed power boating. Why? Because I believe this mindset is absolutely necessary to make the green transformation on the water. Let me give you some examples. Now, this is a family car. It carries four people, travels for 2 hours at a speed of 50 kilometers an hour, and covering a distance of 100 kilometers. During this trip, this car consumes 6 liters of gasoline. This is a family boat. It also carries these four people. It also travels for 2 hours at 50 kilometers an hour, equals about 27 knots, covering the same distance, 100 kilometers. During this trip, this boat consumes 120 liters of gasoline. That is 20 times more than a car. 20 times. So let this be clear. Traveling at high speed on the water requires a lot of energy. Actually, it's by far the worst in class when it comes to emission per person per distance, even compared to commercial airplanes. At the same time, the global demand for water-based transportation is increasing. There's also an increasing recreational market. Should we have a chance to meet this demand in a sustainable way, we have two options. Either we reduce the speed, traveling only at low speed, which is quite efficient, or we drastically reduce the amount of energy required to travel at high speed. And considering high speed is important in many cases, we're left with one alternative. We have to find a way to significantly reduce the amount of energy consumed traveling at high speed. How can that be done? I could now give you a 3-hour lecture based on advanced physics and mathematics to prove my points. But for now, I'll take a different approach. So let's do a dive into the animal kingdom. Has anyone here seen an animal traveling at the surface of the water? There are some. You might be thinking of these cute little ducks. Or maybe these weird insects. They all travel on the surface of the water. But has anyone here seen an animal traveling at the surface of the water at high speed and for long distance, similar to a conventional boat? No. Because there are none. Evolution has concluded that in order to be efficient, you either travel in the air or you travel fully submerged, also known as a bird and a fish, which again has inspired us to develop planes and submarines. But for high-speed boats, we cannot copy nature. We need to think differently. So what if we combine the wings of the bird and the hydrodynamics of the fish and applied it to boats? What if we attached a pair of submerged wings to the hull, lifting the boat out of the water? Not only would these provide a comfortable ride above the waves, not slamming in waves, but it would also be super efficient. And these wings are called a hydrofoil. And the boat becomes a hydrofoil boat. It flies above the water. Remembering that 1% that I spent 30 years chasing? This is a very different ballgame. For hydrofoil boats, we're talking a reduction in energy consumption of 80% compared to conventional boats. 80. So let's go back to our example here. Remembering that car, it used 6 liters. The boat used 120 liters. A similar boat will only use 24 liters on hydrofoil. And now we're talking, right? Well, this pile here is 20 times more than this car. This is only 4 times more. And just to be clear, the beauty of hydrofoil is that it doesn't care whether your boat is powered by battery, hydrogen, or fossil fuel. Its only mission in life is to reduce the energy consumption. So isn't hydrofoil a brilliant idea? I would love to stand here today saying that this is my invention. But it's not. I'm 100 years late. Now this is Graham Bell, the inventor of the telephone. He was also a pioneer in this field. This is him foiling 105 years ago. So if hydrofoils are highly efficient, it's been around for 100 years, why aren't we all flying around today? Well, flying a boat efficiently is very challenging. It's not boating, it is aviation. And through history, there has been many attempts. Ferries, navy, recreation boats. The knowledge has always been there, but the technology to bring it to life was lagging behind. Therefore, most of these cases were not commercially a success. However, unluckily, the world is moving forward. Over the last 20 years, there's been a massive development in technology. And this solves the problem that the previous hydrofoil boats had, linked to weight and propulsion system and control system. And today, you can actually go online and buy a hydrofoil boat or a hydrofoil kit. It is available. So if hydrofoils are highly efficient, it's been around for more than 100 years, we have the technology and it is available. Why aren't we all flying around today? What's the last brick of the puzzle? I'm sorry to say, guys, that's you. Your ability to adapt. The green transformation on the water will not happen unless you adapt the technology. Whether you're an individual, boat operator, or boat manufacturer, now it's your turn to embrace it. And don't meet foiling with skepticism. Meet it with curiosity, excitement, and a let's try mentality. To help you along, I'll give you some insight into my first foiling experience. We were on a seemingly conventional boat, cruising along at low to medium speed. It was a bit bumpy, noisy. Then the speed increased and something happened. The boat started lifting. We had takeoff. and suddenly we're flying half a meter above the waves. It was quiet, it was stable, it was calm. Turning my head around, there was no wake behind the boat. I could easily feel that the resistance was basically gone. And it was like slicing through melted butter with a hot knife. It was smooth. It was a completely new boating experience. And I wanted to share that feeling with everyone, the foiling sensation, making traveling from A to B an unforgettable and sensational experience in itself. I actually wanted it so much that I started a business within the hydrofoil space. So I spent those 30 years of my life chasing the 1%, and I will spend the rest of my life chasing those 80. And my promise to you is that I, together with the whole hydrofoil industry, will make hydrofoil technology accessible to everyone. What I hope you can promise me is to meet this technology with curiosity and embrace its benefit. Because to make the green transformation on the water, we need you on board. I would like to end this talk with a quote. What if I fall? But darling, what if you fly? Thank you.